Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my jungle. Welcome to the jungle. So today I'm gonna be starting a two-part mini golden doodle series on how to groom your golden doodle at home. You guys, you can do it. I know it seems like a daunting task. It seems very difficult, very hard. Your groomer that you go to is probably like, don't do it. Don't do it at home. Of course don't do it at home because that's $100 that I won't be getting. So my golden doodles each, even though Bea is smaller than Max, she still costs me $100, if not a little bit more, $100 to $120 a dog to get them groomed, to get them haircut, and to get them washed and dry. So they can smell good. So why do you have to groom your golden doodle in the first place? Because they don't have fur. That's why they're hyperallergenic. They don't shed because they have hair. Like we have hair. So they have curly hair. So first off, you need to groom them because her hair will continue to grow until they look like a woolly mammoth. Oops. And two, they have curly hair, or a majority of them do, and mine especially do, and their hair will get matted. So you need to comb them, and it'd be best to kind of keep their hair cut like short. Because I've had my dog's hairs long and mats everywhere. You can't keep up with that, no matter how many times you comb their hair a day. So grooming them is best. And I groom mine once a month. And I'm gonna share with you guys in this series how to do it. So first we're cutting their hair. Always cut their hair first and then wash them and shampoo them, because you don't wanna be washing extra hair that you're just gonna chop off anyways. Waste time. And why do that? So today's video, I'm gonna show you guys how to do a short summer haircut on your golden doodle. Even if you don't do your golden doodle as short as I do my golden doodle, just add a guard to your trimmers and you can do it whatever size you want. That's how simple it is. If you want a longer haircut, you add guards. So I'm doing her very, very short in the body and then giving her a little poof on top, and then really keeping her short around the face, because that way she doesn't get an infection in her mouth from hair in her mouth constantly. That definitely can happen. Or infections in their eyes because there's hair in their eyes, and all that kind of stuff. So that can happen. So keeping their face clear is my preference, but if you don't want to do that, then don't do that. So you guys, I recommend you guys buying these things at home, like buying the trimmers and the guards and stuff like that. It is so worth the investment, because like I said, $200 a month is not cheap, and honestly, that would pay for everything you possibly would need to groom them at home in luxury. So definitely recommend everything that I'm using today. It's worth it. But yeah, I hope you enjoy, and let's get started with how I cut their hair here at home. No matter where you decide to cut your golden doodle's hair, I definitely have a tip for you. Put down one of these tablecloths. You get them from the dollar store. It's an easy cleanup if you do that. So I'm gonna get a comb, I'm gonna get a brush, and these are my two favorites. You can find them at Petco or PetSmart. And I'm gonna use them to really comb your doggy out. And you wanna comb her entire hair out before you go in with the clippers, because you wanna get the mats out, you wanna get the tangles out so that your blade doesn't catch on the skin, and it's just an easier time cutting their hair. So I will be giving her a really short haircut on her body, and I am gonna be cutting her muzzle as well. Something to remember is to make sure to work downwards. I like to start with the face and make sure that your blade is kind of flat against their skin. So before I get started, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna spray my blade down. Definitely get this spray. It's amazing. It cleans it, disinfects it, and helps it to work the way it's supposed to. Now, really important, you use the blade 10 for the face and the blade 7 for the body. Never use 7 on the face, because the blades are further apart and they can catch on her skin and cut her. So you definitely don't want that. So
make sure to use a 7 only on the body. And either of these you can use guards with to make the haircut longer if you want. So I'm going ahead and I'm starting with the face, and I'm really getting in there and going around her face. Now, do not use this small size on their ears. Whatever size you use on top of the head, you can use on the ears. I'm leaving the top of the head the same size because I like that it's poofy up there and I like to put a bow on it. So I'm going in and I'm just going around the face and above her eyes to really clear it out so I don't have to cut her as soon. Now I'm going to switch to the 7 blade and I'm going to go through and cut her body, and I'm doing it very, very short. This is the size that you do if you have lots of mats in your dog, if the hair is really matted. If not, you can always add a guard to it to make it longer, but I'm going to stand her up. So I start and kind of let her get comfortable, but then I stand her up. You always want to move backwards in a backwards motion, but then in the middle of their body down, you want to move down. So that's the way it's going to be blended the best. So I'm not even done cutting her hair, and you can see how much hair there is in there and how easy of a cleanup it is when you use a tablecloth method. But anyways, like I said, you in the middle of her body you want to work downwards, but in the top half of her body you want to work backwards. So when you get to the legs, you want to be so careful around their legs. I'm going to show you, you don't want to catch any skin and cut her skin. So you definitely want to be careful. Always have them standing up. I find it's the easiest way. I'm going to leave a poof at the bottom of her tail. I definitely recommend leaving some long hair at the bottom because their tail is short and it will just look odd if you cut it all the way down. So if you lift the opposite leg when you are trimming the opposite leg, it's easy. So this is another tip. And you don't want to catch that skin. You see what I'm talking about? So that's why keeping them stood up is the best. And around the butt, you want to go in that kind of circular motion so that you don't cut it too short around their tailbone slash bum bone, because they have really pointy hips. So if you cut it too short around there, it's just gonna look odd, and lots of groomers have told me that. So that's a little tip as well. When I'm cutting her belly, I do lay her down like that because you can see she's like totally relaxed. She'll take a nap and she's just calm, and it's just a calming experience. So that's it, you guys. Give them a treat when they're done so they can associate cutting their hair with a treat and a good experience, and good luck.
I hope you enjoyed and I hope you found it easy. Like I said, if you want a longer haircut on your doodle, go for it. Add some guards. If you want the poof to be smaller, add some guards and go through and cut the top. If you don't want it super short around the face, then don't do it. Just do it really short around the muzzle, and then you can go ahead and use guards. So very, very simple. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Make sure you come back because I'm going to share with you life-saving products on shampooing and drying their hair. Things that you need to have that aren't really expensive, they're super affordable, that is just gonna make your life 10 times easier and make it so much shorter to groom them, which is so awesome, and just easier and make it look better, because you can't spend an hour drying them with a hair dryer. Like, that doesn't work. So I'm gonna share some awesome tips and stuff in my next video for how to shampoo and dry them, because their hair, if you don't know, will not dry on its own. It will take hours and hours of them sitting out in the sun drying because their hair is crazy. So you definitely want to dry them, and using a hair dryer just don't work. It takes too long, guys. It takes too long. So make sure you come back for that video. You guys, subscribe to my jungle, hit the like, and also comment below what kind of golden doodly videos do you guys want to see. Let me know down below. But yeah, I guess I'll see you guys next time. Bye.